Gus, wake up, buddy. It's time for the podcast, Gus. Come on. I know you want to roll. Get up.
Oh, give me 5 more minutes.
Come on, man. Get up. We got to record. We're recording right now. This is part of the episode. What a twist. The part where I wake you up before every podcast is actually part of the episode this time.
You said that you weren't going to tell people that I would sleep up until we recorded every time, Eddie.
Well, I at least won't tell them about how you put the whole microphone in your mouth and suck it while you're sleeping like a pacifier. And that's horrifying to hear on Discord.
You said that CRISPR killed the sound when I did that.
Dude, I actually got to, I think, turn you up on Discord. But for people who are watching the video version of the podcast... there's a couple of things that are different, not permanently different for one of them. I'm in my stream room right now because the laptop I used to record just shit itself right before we were going to record. And it's just like completely shutting off whenever I open Discord. So now I'm in my stream room. And Gus, where are you?
I am in my house. There aren't acoustic panels, so it's going to be echoey in here a little bit. I'm in the new place, guys. Thank you, everybody, again. Last week, dude, I won't dive right into this, but fucking the internet, oh my god, we tried for 3 straight fucking weeks to get internet. Holy shit, as of recording this, people, it is Saturday morning, and I just got internet installed like 8 p.m. last night.
When did you start? Was it 7 days ago?
Dude, no, we started getting the internet over 2 weeks ago because it was before we moved. Like, Sabrina tried getting, you know, she called ahead and was like, can we do this? Hey, can we move the router over and stuff? And we kept, they were like, I'm not even going to go and tell the whole story to you beautiful listeners out there, but I can't stress enough, and Eddie knows this too. It was like a dozen major signposts of like people saying like, yep, you will definitely have it on this day. And it just didn't happen. Like appointments would go missing and people had no record of it. People didn't show up. A cable underground was broken and shit. It was such a fucking colossal clusterfuck. Eddie, I haven't watched this much network television in the last probably 5 fucking years.
And let me make a guess. It's bad.
It is so bad. I know. Oh my god. I think Drew did a video about like the how bad television is, I think, a number of months ago. Was that Drew?
How bad like network shows are?
Yeah, like how compromising of experience television is.
I don't think I've ever missed a Drew video, so I'm going to pull up the channel right now cuz I know he's
No, I'm scared. Oh frick.
Hold on. We're speaking of our friend Drew Gooden. So,
yes,
just for everybody.
Television is a confusing, expensive
right,
mess.
Right, of course. Yeah, okay.
I had the word network in my head, so I was like, I don't think network, but the confusing
I kept trying
mess.
To picture his Boom. Late night video. I'll say, not intended, Drew and I have, like, one of the, I think, best pairings of two videos of, like, accidental uploads, where I made a video on late night and then was like, I'm at the very end, here are my thoughts on Lily Singh, but I'm not really going to get into it. And then Drew uploaded a Lily Singh right after we were both working on them at the same time. And the algorithm was like, watch both of these, everybody. And they both did really well. His much better than mine. Okay, Gus?
Oh,
way
dude,
better.
Stop.
Colossally better. That's okay.
First you wake me up, now you yell at me? Ow.
One thing, I'm drinking coffee out of, do you remember these awesome fucking mugs we got sent from one of the boys before? It's the one that says our names on them.
Mm-hmm. Beautiful.
Dude, I should get you yours. I'm still using yours over here if you want it. It's the,
Good.
The keyboard one.
You can use it. Please don't put your lips or teeth on it, though, okay?
So what I do essentially, you can't see it. I'll do it on me, is I'll put my hand near your crotch on it, and as I drink, I'll just kind of rub.
I don't think that is necessary or something we should be doing.
Yeah, but
do you hear me?
Do you hear me going, that means the drink's really good. When did that start? I feel like I only do that because I was told to do that by observing other people. I don't feel like I ever... When you were a kid, did you have the natural inclination to go... Where did that come from?
I wish that I did. I don't know. I think we were testing this before. We were trying to take like actual like drinks and then just see if you just nonchalantly, naturally go into the... even a little bit. I don't know what reaction elicits that.
Did we talk about that before? Am I that predictable, Gus? Am I just looping back?
You're not looping back. You are loopy, but I don't even know. Okay. Anymore.
Here's one thing I'll say from my tweet yesterday. I know you saw it. And I'm going to put this out there. It's an opinion I want to put out there.
Please do.
I'm not a scientist. But I think, and hear me out, Gus, if you put a fish, any fish, in a bowl of Hawaiian punch, it'll do just fine.
I saw that. And that, first of all, is a hilarious tweet. But I'm thinking, probably, right?
Listen, I don't know any of the science of it, but I'm sure whatever Hawaiian punch doesn't have in that water has, it makes up for in punch, you know? And I'm sure that does something to, like, activate the gills or some shit, you know? But I'm sure it's fine.
Yeah, like this vitamin C flows through the gills, because that's a great source of vitamin C and part of a balanced breakfast anyway. So
here's what fucks me up.
I assume it just filters the toxins out.
I think we talked about this before. The calorie count on Hawaiian Punch is shocking.
It's insane. It's insulting, kind of, honestly.
It's shockingly low, I'm saying, right? That's what we're on the same page, or?
Oh, we're on the same page, dude. Yeah. Okay, It's like, what the fuck? What are you doing, Hawaiian Punch? God damn it. I was supposed to eat other shit in a day. I can't just be drinking Hawaiian Punch all fucking day.
Wait, I'm confused now. Wait, so we're both saying it's low calorie, right?
Oh, I thought it was off the fucking charts, dude.
No, dude. I think the sugar's really high. But here, one sec. Calories, can of Hawaiian Punch. We've definitely talked about this on the podcast.
Are you going to lowball me on the calories? I thought it was through the fucking roof, dude.
Wait, is it? Wait. No, that's 21 ounces. That's too much.
What's a can? I wish I would have saved a can of the Tahitian treat to double check.
80 calories per can, dude.
What? That's like less than soda. I feel like that's way less than soda.
Wait, I have to make sure that this source is right. Or, you know what I could do? I could just not keep looking. Wait, no, it's 100 flat. But still, for Hawaiian Punch, I would have expected that to be off the fucking charts.
Oh, God, yeah. I mean, it's just like, it's the sugariest shit you've ever drank.
Here's the thing. I am in a good mood today, and that's pretty rare, you know? So don't test me, and let's keep it positive. I just want to say that right off the bat.
Don't get on my bad side. You're like the sassy girl from work who wears her hair up in a ponytail and doesn't take no sass.
That's me. And also, I realized that because you didn't have internet last week, I don't want to talk about it at all, but I feel like there's an elephant in the room of, like, we're living through, like, a triple Watergate, and we're just, like, talking about Hawaiian Punch, you know?
Right?
Like, this is, things are getting pretty crazy out there, huh, Gus? What do you think?
I'd say, in a word, goofy. Yeah.
I would say things are pretty goofy. I think things got goofy in D.C. last week.
Dude, you know what? Honestly, too, like, and this is a completely apolitical thing, couldn't have thought of a more cosmically terrible time to be completely devoid of internet for, like, 2 weeks.
Oh,
it was,
yeah,
like, the day after we moved in, the fucking capital shit went down, and, like, and we were moving, and I was trying to do podcasts, Twitch stream, all this other shit, and it was just, like, every night, you know, those are the kind of things, especially the day that it happened and, like, the day after, and then for, like, the impeachment proceedings and stuff, like, that is the kind of thing where it's, like, if you can afford to do so time-wise, drop everything, watch the news all fucking day, and we've just got little cell phones with shitty cap data T-Mobile hotspot shit, so we're, like, Sabrina and I spent so many nights, like, crowded around her tiny little 10-inch MacBook screen trying to do a shitty hotspot trading off between the two of us, watching Hassan in, like, 144p at a distance so we couldn't see any text, just see the shape of shit. Oh, fuck that noise, dude.
You know what's going to be so annoying? Did you think about how when we are, like, parents, our kids are definitely going to ask us about last week for, like, a... like, go home and talk to your parents about what it was like. And it's like, please don't. I don't want to do it.
I don't want to talk about it. Yeah.
I don't want to. Well, like, we're talking about it here, but we're not talking about it here. You know, it's like, I just don't.
Oh, yeah. It is such a meme, too. This is absolutely not an original thought. But, like, truthfully, it's astonishing at how much just absolute history we've lived through in the last year. Like, I don't fucking like it, but it really is, like, There's probably like 10 different weeks that are going to be like textbook chapters in and of themselves just from the last fucking year for the next 40 years.
I think what's hilarious to me, and we can thank, I feel like especially our audience for this, is like... I feel like my kids are going to go on a Google thing of like, what was it like during the pandemic? And they're going to find like Twitch clips of me doing like teeth time and like downing White Claws. And it's just like, what is, it's so weird that the pandemic also includes like the biggest moments in like gaming, online gaming history, kind of, you know? It's weird, like Among Us popping off during a pandemic is just, it all makes sense, but it's just weird.
Dude, it is so fucking weird, honestly. And you know what? You said it before, too. And we're not diving too deep into the shit, but, like, it has felt so strange trying to do anything other than pay attention to, like, this terrible fucking catastrophic mess of a situation, you know? Where it's like, I'll be like, oh, I want to go shoot a little sketch. And then, like, hey, yeah, the world's on fire. And I'm getting, like, Maggie Haberman tweet notifications, New York Times every 5 minutes of, like, this happened, that guy died, oh, my God. It's like, oh, fucking hell.
That's what, and I know, I'm sure people listening are fucking tired of hearing me talk about, like, certain upload stuff with, but that's what happens with my commentary videos mainly. Because, I mean, really, I was thinking about this yesterday. It's like, I still consider my, like, 100% main job still uploading YouTube videos, you know? Mm-hmm. But, like, we do really, and they're all, like, very cushy, like, kind of easy ones. But we do have, like, multiple jobs that, like, some creators only do one of the things that we do, right? Mm-hmm. And it's, like, when it comes to something now, and I'm sure a bunch of our audience can agree, because I'm sure a bunch of you guys do stuff creatively. It's, like, what the fuck kind of commentary topic am I supposed to pick this week? You know what I mean? Like, what am I supposed to be like, prank YouTubers are back at it again? Like, the Capitol got stormed. Like,
yeah.
Is that a prank video? Because if it's not, you know, which I don't even make videos on anymore. But it's like, I don't know. It's why I end up, like, streaming more and doing the podcast. And also, a fun announcement. Tony and I wrote and are recording the first video of that... that video essay channel we wanted to do together.
Hell yeah.
So that's actually moving now. I saw a bunch of people kept tweeting me at it. Not a bunch. A couple. Let's say a couple. I'm not...
Everybody did. Let's face it. Every single guy.
It was like... anyways, we're working on that, which we really want to get moving, and I'm saying it now so you guys can pressure me into it. And if you don't see an upload in the next, like, 3 weeks, then we failed.
Nice. I'm excited to watch that. That's going to be a bop and a half. Of course, folks, you'll know the links will be in the description. Not this one, idiots. Not done. Did you open your ears for one time?
We're in the middle of this thing, dude.
God. Sorry about that, Eddie.
I also have another question for you. I saw people theorizing it on our subreddit.
Yes.
Do you think that Mayor Monkey was behind what happened at the Capitol last week?
You know what? I saw a lot of, you know, places reporting, New York Times, CNN. There's speculation.
There's speculation, but I feel like there's silence, and it makes me a little bit suspicious of, like, is he paying somebody in the media to, like, kind of, you know, place the blame somewhere else? For people that don't know, who haven't seen the podcast episode we're referencing, when we were at Disney World, we were theorizing about monkey takeover at Disney World and then the apes becoming very smart and their leader is Mayor Monkey. And of course. I feel like, Gus, we can't like write him out.
We can't rule it out.
We
can't. Is the biggest thing. And I think the big takeaway is it's like, you know, I don't want to be that guy, but I really feel like it would not be that hard to release a statement. If you saw the first Planet of the Apes movie and the weakest of the three of the most recent ones, you will know that Caesar the monkey was able to conjure a simple no. And like, this feels like it's a yes or no question. Someone should just sit Mayor Monkey down. Did you do that? Did you storm the Capitol?
No.
And this That's is all one we thing. Need.
And listen, I'll say it, Gus. I don't care if I get canceled. I don't care what happens when I say this. This is a message to Mayor Monkey. No more monkey business, man.
No more monkey business.
No more monkey business. Gus and Eddie podcast says no more monkey bit. No, listen. So I tripped up on my words a second ago, and I asked Tony to cut it out, and maybe he did successfully. Maybe you noticed a cut a second ago. I fucked it up again, and this is exactly why Mayor Monkey needs to give us answers.
Come on, man. Eddie can't talk. Make the monkey start talking. He can't say one word.
It's ridiculous. No more monkey business. That's my new catchphrase. Somebody make a political ad of me. Wait. Hold on. I'm going to pose for it. And then put no more monkey business next to me. Kind of like the Obama Hope ad.
No more. I don't think that Shepherd Fairey can fit that many text letters underneath that. No more monkey business.
It's tiny. Pretty compromised. It's still the vertical like movie poster dimensions, but it says no more monkey business like spread out in it.
Yeah, that'll work.
It's written on like Mulaney did that bit about writing happy birthday on a sign. And then no more is huge. And then monkey business is like fit in.
That's all you need. That's the spacing.
I think... Well, what have you been playing anything lately? I don't want to do a huge gamer talk, but what's up?
God of War, I finally started it. Da, 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 da,
da. Let's go!
I did it.
I don't want to spoil anything for anyone in the audience, but how many like hours have you played?
I would say, and calculate this. I think you can probably subtract 30% of the story that you assume I'm at, just because you know I'm a slow guy that's got to check every corner.
Oh, I did the same thing with God of War. I really like did all kind of like side shit.
Okay, yeah, I would say I'm probably about 12 hours in at least, if not 15 or so.
Okay, so I would say especially to, because I know a lot of people aren't, you know, that listen to us aren't gamers, so I don't want to get into the specifics, but I would say if you don't play any games, maybe watch a playthrough of God of War. It's an incredible story, and that's I'll say.
It's pretty. I will say, I mean, I love the game. The art, I like the character stuff.
The music is fucking, wow.
Music is great. Oh, my God. Honestly, the art direction is the biggest takeaway for me. Like, all the different environments are so gorgeous. Mm-hmm. I also, like you said, you know, the combat's great. Sucking that axe back. Thump. That's super great.
Oh, man, dude. If you could, imagine if you could do that in real life. Oh, also, actually, I want to show... I gotta grab something real quick, all right? Stall for me.
All right, guys. So I've been playing a little bit of God of War stuff because I have not had internet, and that was one of the only ones that I had locally downloaded on my PS4. What else we've been doing is watching network TV, and it's been a little bit strange. And I'm sure Eddie and I will talk about this when we get back, but there's something kind of nice about having not a lot of stuff to choose from sometimes. You throw on the TV and you're like, look at that kind of show that's okay is on. I guess I'll watch that and shut up and be happy and eat a frozen pizza. And maybe that's not so bad sometimes. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure you do. Back to you, Eddie.
Okay. So I have it, but I have to take a picture first to send to you. And then, so you can see it at the same time as the audience, you know?
Okay.
Okay, hold on.
I'm looking right at the Discord.
All right, I got to get two. I'll just send you the one with the cover on it. Okay. So, during... there was like, I'd say maybe a month and a half ago, maybe 2 months ago, mm-hmm. Chrissy and I got super into God of War. I had already played it. Chrissy hadn't. And I loaded up my old save and started playing more of it. And she played through it, I think like twice. And we were both just kind of obsessed with it for a month. I told you I mm-hmm. bought a Norse mythology book. Mm-hmm. I'm just going to send you this to you personally and not in our Discord so people don't see how messy the room is. There's a knocked over tequila bottle from one of the streams from
get
the
your
New Year's
life
Eve one.
Together, dude.
All right. God. So Chrissy, for Christmas, got me this.
Whoa! Huck it, dude.
Dude, and then on the when I take the cover off, I'll send you a picture right now, Gus. And for audio listeners, sorry, it's an axe, like a Nordic axe. And then in, I don't know how accurate it is, but in like runes, it has the four letters on it. It's my name, dude.
Whoa. It's how the hell did she even get that?
She had it custom made like on Etsy or something. And wow. It's like, it's a legit axe. It's a real axe. And I could fucking,
I'll drive outside. Throw it down to me. I'll throw it back. I promise.
That's what I'm saying. Watch out,
dude. That is really badass. That looks fucking beautiful, dude.
Dude, and this is what I was telling this to Chrissy. Imagine, like, I know, you know, for home safety, everyone's always got to have like a taser or something, right?
Mm-hmm.
But imagine you're a home invader, intruder is what I meant. Not invader. You're not an alien. And instead of coming at you with like a baseball bat, you see me standing there with an axe.
Oh my God, dude.
And with a Nordic axe that you could throw. You're going to turn right back around.
I wouldn't intrude upon one more home for the rest of my career, dude.
Because for real, it's like, I mean, I would say an axe is one of the most terrifying things to get hit with, you know?
Probably.
Like, and so I feel like if I saw that, I'd be like, all right, this guy, he's got a fucking axe. We can't even go near this dude. And then, as you know, I do my normal home intruder method where I drop the axe, I throw a vase on the ground, I jump down on it ass first, and I go, ouch, owie, my ass! And then he leaves because he's too embarrassed.
Yeah, that's just a 1-2 punch, dude. Just, oh, God, I don't want to die. It always works. And this guy, ugh, okay, I'm out of here.
I'll make, hopefully I'll remember, a post to the subreddit of a picture. Actually, wait, I don't have to. You can look up the video if you're an audio listener. Never mind. That.
Dude, that's cool as hell, honestly. That's fucking awesome.
Yeah, it was a great fucking gift. I was really happy with it. And so, imagine if I could throw it and suck it back into my hand, dude, like Kratos.
Man, dude, I will say, because I want to, well, I got two quick things. First of all, I was telling you before the podcast, you guys maybe saw on Twitter, I also got a cool Christmas gift from my girlfriend.
Oh, yeah,
and it got
shit.
Fucking stolen. Sabrina got me some custom handmade acoustic panels with a beautiful scene of Rivendell on them. That's my desktop background. And I was just
Rivendell is from Lord of the Rings for people who are unaware.
Yeah, it's where those elves live. It's where Lord Elrond is just chilling and stuff. It's beautiful. God damn, I'm so pissed about that. So we're trying to figure that out, fix it, but fuck that shit. My second thing is that my final God of War thought is I love the game. I love everything about it. The only thing I don't like, and this is just personal preference, I think, is the menu system is so
text is too small.
Convoluted. Not even the small text, it's just so much fucking information, especially when you're starting out.
I completely agree, but the game kind of gets deeper than in gameplay than just a base story game, and then you do need all of those. But it is like confusing and fucking confusing as fucking overwhelming, especially in the beginning.
Because it's one of those things where I'm like, I know that this has got to be a really comprehensive system that covers all the bases, but especially the intro, because, you know, I'm 12 to 15 hours in now. Like,
yeah.
I have no way of knowing, hey, what the fuck am I supposed to be doing? It's like, the first thing I got was I got a bunch of, like, gear and shit, and I was like, oh, I can craft some stuff, and then I spent all of my money and shit crafting, and I'm like, wait a minute, did I just fucking craft a bunch of, like, beginner-tier dumb shit? I have no way of knowing, because it's like, dude, there comes a time where it's like, you'll play like 10 minutes or so, and then it'll be like, yo, you got this thing. Go in the menu. And it's just like, dude, I can't flip through 10 text slides of like, this is your this bar. This does this when you do that. I'm like, I'm not absorbing this. I'm still in the fucking world. I don't know what I'm supposed to be saving and shit. So I'm sure I'll figure it out, but that kind of stuff is like, I've said it before. I sound like an old man on my porch, but fucking video game menus and screens and shit, dude. Like, sometimes they're so overwhelming, and it's just like, just give me some clean shit with not a lot of info on it. You don't always need all that shit, but.
Yep.
But that's just a little old me.
Yeah, well, that's a little old you. We can't deny that. We can't keep you away from it. Here's one thing that I want to say we talked about before that I'm very excited about. Well, one thing, positive thing, if you guys have not been paying attention, looks like vaccine news is looking up. Which is good.
Let's hope.
But, one, just so people know again, I don't think we have to explain it this time because everyone knows how bad LA is right now for us doing the podcast in person. But, like, second, we're vaccinated. First week, we're doing the podcast in person.
Absolutely.
But also, I think we've definitely talked about it on the podcast before. I'm so excited. Gus and I are going to start our tradition again of getting some brekkie and scooting around.
Oh, God, just you saying that, dude. I'm like, dude.
But here's what we were talking about on the phone before is for people listening. You know, we're in a different era now. I can't comfortably touch a Bird scooter's handle. I always thought it was dirty, and I never touched my face or anything or my phone. I would always wash my hands. But now it's, like, extra bad. So I propose that Gus and I get racing gloves. And we go get breakfast. And then outside of the breakfast place, we're putting on our gloves and we're standing on the scooter and we're revving the engine and we'll look so cool. Gus, please be on board with me with this.
I won't be on board at the end in the same scooter with you because we're too over the weight limit. But yes, I'm getting the gloves. We can even get them like copper lined so they disinfect naturally.
Oh, Dude, here's the thing. We got to look up. I want to look up racing gloves and buy the most obnoxious ones that I can find.
I want to get some fucking Evel Knievel gloves with like the like stegosaur things coming off the top of them.
That'd be fucking awesome. Okay, we get breakfast. We're both in like alternate flipped color Evel Knievel suits that are matching. And the helmet and the cape. Ride around in those after breakfast.
Dude, that's good. You know, all it's going to take is one guy to be like, look at these assholes. And just reach out and grab our cape as we're going away.
He doesn't even have to do anything physical to us. We just think we're so cool and we hear, look at these assholes. And then we're just helmet down, pointed at the ground, just sad, moving the scooters forward.
Put our visor down and not even like the thing still has charge, but we like scoot it with our foot home. We're so ashamed.
Dude, I mean, honestly, that's with an Evel Knievel suit, all it takes for you to feel completely embarrassed is somebody to go, look at this guy.
And you're like, he doesn't even need to insult you, man. Oh, I love that. Like, you're so on the brink already of, like, just please don't say anything. Look at this guy. Oh, I'm destroying
him. You're headed toward the ramp over, like, the Grand Canyon. And you're just like, okay, don't, like, keep the throttle down. Like, let's go. Don't get nervous. Don't get nervous. As you're passing the crowd, get a load of this guy.
You skid to a halt.
You skid and it falls and you fucking like just wipe out on the side. Your body slides off the ramp because the motorcycle came off, but you slid forward.
Your manager runs out. You okay? Are you okay? You hurt?
Not on the outside. I have broken every bone in my body, but I've now broken my heart. Bro, what is this that we do? This is part of our job.
I don't know. What the fuck is it? Ah, my brain is melted. Thank you, 2020. This is our job, dude. This is important stuff that we're talking about.
This is important shit that you guys need to hear. This is something that you've signed on for. You ever think about really like somebody who listens to every episode of the podcast, kind of like how much time we've all spent together? I mean, we haven't spent it. We don't know each other, so let's keep that barrier there still. Like, we're not best buds. I'm not like, hey, guys, but for real, like, that's crazy. I think of podcasts that I listened to before, and I, like, knew the creator's personality. Doesn't that freak you out? Sometimes I'm about to go to bed, and I'm like, people, like, there's a good deal of people that might know all my flaws.
Yeah, that's really strange, especially, too, I think when I've started to go over to, like, and I'm sure you probably feel the same, like, when we've guested on other people's, whether it's podcasts or just, like, a show or channel or whatever, like, it's strange when it's somebody that you have been listening to for just dozens and dozens and dozens of hours, and then they'll just, like, make references or, like, they'll tell you, like, a story and, like, explain something to you, and it was like, I heard you say that in 2018.
Yeah.
Like,
it's cool. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, that's also, there's a really bizarre thing where we both know, with your own podcast, you can, if you say something and you're like, I don't really like how that came off, or I was just kind of talking and I don't even believe what I just said, you can just cut it out, you know? Mm-hmm. And that's the panic when you go on somebody's podcast is sometimes you just say shit on a podcast just because you need shit to say. You know, sometimes I'll say, I mean, even not on a podcast, sometimes I'll just say something and be like, I don't even believe that. Why I say that?
Exactly. I'm trying to think. I don't think I've fucked up anybody else's podcast yet, but it's that level of scrutiny that you have to like look at yourself for of like, uh-oh, like what did I say anything?
Yeah, it's not even like a fuck up exactly, but it's like even sometimes if I haven't just a like a joke about something, not even if it goes too far or anything, because we don't really do that. We're not like edgy dudes. It's just, I don't know. It's like, you know, sometimes I'll tell Tony like, I don't like that the way that sounded of what I just said, you know, and it's just it's frightening to me where it's like you go on Phil's podcast and there's like a set. You know,
yeah.
It's just like, oh, this is like a legit operation. And there's like same with H3, you know, there's like three or four people listening in. And then the live podcast, holy shit. That's still, people are like, you ever going to do a couple of live ones? No. We dox ourselves far too often to do a full live podcast.
Oh yeah, dude, we'd fuck shit up pretty bad. We'd start in and say, guys, hey, here's my home address. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh!
Oh shit, can we go back?
And wait, no. we'd be in the microphones. Hey, club staff, is it too late to get those Dave Chappelle cell phone bags so people don't record? Do you have to go? Okay.
Hey guys, thank you so much for watching the podcast. And thank you, Scouts Honor, for sponsoring today's podcast. Listen, guys, as pet parents, working from home has given us, that's me and Sabrina, more time to spend with our four-legged family members. Now we're more aware of their daily needs, health issues, and their well-being. So, if you've noticed that your pet is itchy or smells less than pleasant, you have to check out Scouts Honor. Scouts Honor is a go-to pet brand for grooming products that will help itch relief, odor control, and overall healthier skin and coat. All right, they got some fantastic products. They smell wonderful too. My favorite smell, a little bit of that lavender. Who doesn't like a little lavender, huh? Scouts Honor's probiotic grooming products are a scientifically proven natural solution for treating your pet's skin problems. When applied to the skin, probiotics support healthy bacteria and fight against bad bacteria that can cause irritation. With every purchase, Scouts Honor provides 1 day's worth of meals for a rescue animal in need. That sounds pretty cool, a little rescue animal. That ain't too bad. With Scouts Honor, your pet will never look, feel, or smell better. Check out all of Scouts Honor's award-winning products today. Available online or wherever pet supplies are sold. To receive 20% off your first order, go to scoutshonor.com/GusAndEddie. Remember, that's Scouts with a K at scoutshonor.com/GusAndEddie for 20% off your order. Scouts Honor, natural and preventative grooming solutions for pets. Thank you so much for sponsoring. Okay, go away. Go back to the episode. Bye.
You know what I was thinking is pre-pandemic, I feel like I finally conquered that stupid anxiety of when you're at a restaurant and you're nervous about fucking up your order to the server.
And I feel
like this year has erased all the progress I had since we moved out here. Think about ordering to a server right now. Think about how foreign that feels.
Oh my God.
Because Gus and I haven't been to a restaurant this entire time. So like,
you know what? And I'm fucking proud of that shit, dude.
Oh, I thought you were going to say you have. I was like, huh?
No. Yeah, Jesus Christ. Anyway, yeah, I think it's important to keep saying this sometimes, even if it is a little cock of the walk. But no, I know exactly what you mean. Like, I don't even know. Like, in the limited amount of times that I've had to interact with people, you know, like, guys, I have a secret project I can't talk about right now, but I'm working with a cool new company from some stuff that you'll see soon off of the side. But I was doing a shoot yesterday, actually, and the company had to drop off a couple of props and tech equipment like outside our place, and you know, they just came up, everyone was all masked up, and they were just leaving stuff in the driveway, you know. But even then, I was just like, this is the first time that I've interacted with like another kind of like crew out here, like a professional person out here since the start of the pandemic, you know. Mm-hmm. Like, I've seen Eddie a few times outside with like beer stuff, you know, and like, But you just walk up and it's just like, hey guys, what's going on? You know, yeah. Like, you don't know what the fuck to say. It's like I used to swing by like Smosh and Mythical and shit, and it's just like, you know, the whole crew's there and you see everybody, and it's not with them, by the way. But like, I'm just like, I don't know how to fucking talk to people, let alone in that high pressure situation of having to order a specific thing at a restaurant.
Dude,
I'm fucked.
We're fucked. It's like, you know that moment where you're like, don't fuck it up. It's just, hey, bro, it's chicken tenders. You can't say anything wrong, you know? And then it's like, as they get to you, you're like, all right, I'm going to look. And I think I said the same thing to Chrissy. And she said, like, pretending to inspect the menu like you're still searching, yeah. But you're really just reading it in your head. Also, you know what's one thing I love being? And I know you're the same way, too. This is a social thing that I do miss. I love being the guy that's just stopping by.
I always, you know, love that, dude.
I love when I just gotta like swing. If it's like, you know, post pandemic, I gotta swing by your place and grab something. Swing by, we talk a bit, I'm out. That's, man. I love that. Going to a party, just coming into a conversation, saying hi to somebody, bouncing, going to get a drink somewhere else. I love that. I love saying hey and then being like, I'm out. It's my favorite.
Man, I absolutely love that kind of shit. It's just good. It's fun. You can be, you don't have to be on the whole time, depending on the situation. Oh, you can pop in and be like, what was it? All right.
That's what we do. Gus and I walk around parties going, yo, what's up?
We're basically like the honeycomb guy just going around parties. Just fucking drooling at people.
Are there still like a ton of, and I'm not saying this of like times have changed. We don't see these ads. Are they still running a ton of cereal mascots?
I don't know. I think they're still doing heavy on the Trix and the Lucky Charms shit. I think I saw some stuff for that last year, but I don't know.
I bet Tony the Tiger is still swinging. Tony the Tiger's not going anywhere.
Oh, dude. No.
And by far the hottest of all of the cereal mascots.
Is Tony the Tiger?
Who else?
Is it because of his coat or his
it's his physique, dude. It's his physique. And also, he's always just trying to help. He's not stealing anything. Does he even give them Frosted Flakes, or is he just like playing baseball near some Frosted Flakes? What is his like motive?
Wouldn't it be funny if he's not even involved with Frosted Flakes? He just keeps being photographed near some Frosted Flakes. he's like, saying, they're great. And he's talking about like Valvoline motor oil or some shit.
I still just love that they had to think of a mascot and they're like, well, he's a tiger. Tony the Tiger. It's genius.
You know what I love about Tony the Tiger, and I had to look it up to reaffirm, is what? When you think about it, like, Tony the Tiger, his back legs are such fucking wimpy little, like, underdeveloped thing to compared to his, like, turbo arms.
Yep. Oh my God. I always got frustrated, even for, like, all the mascots that were either trying to get cereal or trying to keep the cereal from the kids. I really never wanted the kids to get it. I just wanted them to have, like, a moment of peace in their life, you know, like the Lucky Charms guy. I was like, just let him eat the goddamn Lucky Charms.
Why do you eat so much?
And then you remember when Cookie Crisp had the really chill dog that was just in like a hoodie and he'd just be like, hey, I brought some Cookie Crisp. And then they changed it to like Wolf, like Wile E. Coyote trying to get it. And I was like, what?
Did
they put down the Cookie Crisp dog?
Did they happened? That? Can we get some confirmation? Tony?
Can you just text on screen, did they, yes or no? Did they put down the, okay, audio listeners won't have any idea, but that's okay. Unless, actually, Tony, do it text to speech, right here.
Chip the dog is dead.
So, that's Tony's research.
Damn, thank you, Tony. I appreciate it. That is very heartbreaking. And for you, the viewer at home, for only the cost of a cup of coffee every single day, you could save the Cookie Crisp dog from being put down.
I don't think they'll change their mind. I think it's something that they wanted to do. So, like, you can't save them.
Like, it's not that there are too many Cookie Crisp dogs and they had to put them, like, it's that he's, like, a problem dog?
I think somebody, an executive, just had it out for him, you know? I think he found something he shouldn't have found. Some secrets about Cookie Crisp, some dark secrets, you know?
That is, in a word, disappointing. Damn.
Well, what do you say we get to some friggin' preguntas, my man?
Let's do it up. By the way, you probably won't be able to hear anything, Eddie, and it will not be very much at all, but in case you hear a clunk or so, I guess our couch delivery showed up 4 hours earlier than planned. So they're they're in the main room right now, and I'm in the dis room. So good thing we have some separation. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for sending us in your preguntas. It's time for that. That's questions in English, in case you weren't aware. Follow us on Twitter, at Eddie Burback and at Gus Buckets, and we will make your life a little bit better. Anyway, here's here's a question from at Mr. Smiggles 3773, and they ask, can you do the bird call thing with your hands? You know thing?
I don't think I've ever tried it.
They're like, I can't do it, but they're like,
I have no idea.
Man, I could do I don't know. Like, you always see people, like, cup it when put their fingers together, you know?
Yeah, I can't just, like, try and make sounds.
Man, you know what I can do? Do you ever put the little blade of grass between your little thumb cleavage thing and blow?
Oh, I forgot about that. There's a lot of, like, small, you know, or old childhood things that I'm like, I'm just not fucking around outside anymore. When was the last time, and be very honest with me, when was the last time you saw a roly-poly?
Oh, man. Probably in June.
Now that I think, I forgot I was in Wisconsin in June.
You digging around, or they just
on things? I was digging around.
What's your definition of a roly-poly? Because I've heard people attribute that to multiple things. Like, in my mind, the roly-poly is like the kind of dirt grub kind of thing.
Yeah, it's the one with like the armor and the little legs, and it rolls up when you tap the legs.
Okay, yeah, and I've heard people attribute it to woolly bear caterpillars. You know those ones?
I don't know. Let me look it up.
Woolly bear caterpillars are like, and I don't know if that's a colloquial term for it. I'm sure it is, but they're the little caterpillars that are like mega fuzzy. They look like a big scrub brush, and they're like brown and black.
That's not a roly-poly.
Exactly. I was like, what the fuck are you talking about? That's a woolly bear caterpillar, damn it.
What's the official name of a roly-poly?
I don't know. I think roly-poly-olies.
That's it. I actually don't know.
Real Roly name. Little guys? I don't know.
Roly poly, real name. Oh, no wonder we call this shit a fucking... Oh, okay, no. Pill bug, I think, is the kind of nickname. And then The longer one is Armadillidium vulgare. That's, you know, the, like, Latin fucking shit for it. Which is also... That's cool that they named it, like, after an armadillo.
Yeah, I think that's pretty dope.
That's
a little scaled-down version. It's like a Polly Pocket version of an armadillo.
Take it with you.
All right, you got some questions?
I got a little question for you. By the way, before we get off this grass sound thing, guys, I'm not going to do it for you, but I've told you before, I think if you want to make the worst sound known to man, do it at home. I encourage you right now. Go get a piece of paper. Make it a thin piece of paper, maybe some printer paper, something like that, even newspaper. Fold it in half so that it is folded like hamburger style. It doesn't fucking matter. Make the ends right next to each other. Hold it in between your fingers with like an inch or less space and blow in between the two pieces of paper. Why don't you go do that? Blow as hard as you can in the main room of the house. Do it right now. You let me know how it goes. Anyway.
Let them know.
Let me know. Send me the audio recording, please. I'm going to get a bunch of shit in my email of just like the worst shit ever. All right, here we go. At J White XVII, that's probably Roman numerals, but I'm not changing it, asks, you've been put in charge of designing a roadrunner-type trap to stop the Wile E. Coyote, but the coyote is actually a celebrity of your choice. How do you set it up?
What? Wait, so hold on. Are they trying to catch us, or are we just trapping a celebrity? Like,
so in this metaphor, you are the proverbial roadrunner, and... your Wile E. Coyote figure is a celebrity, so how do you design a trap to catch them?
Right. No, I'm just saying. So if they are Wile E. Coyote figure, we're not catching them then, because we're.
Oh, it's a trap though. You got to stop them. Whether you're we got to stop. I know,
but it's like the goal of Wile E. Coyote is to get Roadrunner, and we're a Roadrunner in this situation, right?
Oh, okay. Yeah, I suppose.
Wait, is that what you were asking, or is my brain breaking?
I think we just got to trap the Wile E. Coyote. That's what it says. So we're assuming he's not coming after you. He's
so just we're just tricking him. We're not. I don't think we're trapping him, though. It's like, well, it's like painting trapping on a wall.
But I'm fucking okay. Trapping him.
Okay. That's fine. I mean, I wish they would have given a celebrity so I could think about it. Here, we got to think of a random celebrity.
I know how we trap one.
I got one.
Let me hear yours.
So the Wile E. Coyote is Rob Schneider.
Okay.
And I paint a movie opportunity that says that he won't have to use Adam Sandler's fame to be in something. And and he slams right into the wall. And then, I don't know, I fucking shoot a net at him. I don't shoot him. shoot him. I was going to say shoot him with like a net gun, and I fucking shoot him. That's not what I meant to say. Oh, man.
The wall says, a non-Adam Sandler involved major film project in which we will allow you to play a race of your choosing.
Which is bread and butter, we know. Dude, yeah, how about a lot of Rob Schneider's roles? How about those?
That's one of those ones where it's like, you know, I do, and it does not apply to this thing, but in the general sense, I absolutely agree with this. We've talked with this before. You know, the world of 10 years ago is not the same as today in terms of, like, you know, general comedy stuff and, like, some shit where you're like, oh my god, you look back on some stuff like, that's kind of out of taste. Didn't realize that. That was way more mainstream. Doesn't make it okay, but it was just way easier to be able to do that kind of stuff, you know?
Dude, I would even say, like, 4 years ago. And
I completely agree.
My big suggestion is for people that are much younger than us that are newer to the internet, especially if you're seeing things where you're like, that is not okay. And I'm saying it isn't when we're looking back at those things. Mm-hmm. But watch an early 2000s comedy movie, and you'll get a general vibe of what everyone was okay with, you know?
Yeah, and honestly.
It's insane. But the thing is, you know, even then, there were some things where you're like, can you do that?
That's why, before too much time gets by, I want to say, that being said, the Rob Schneider shit, though, is still like, okay, that seems like you really should have known that's like super fucking shitty to do.
What's your celebrity? What are you doing? This is a confusing question because I feel like there's too many aspects to it.
Well, I'm just focusing on trapping them, all right? So here's the thing. You get all of OJ's trophies and memorabilia. And he just does the rest for you.
Because we know, because he's already done it. He's already done it once.
You hear OJ coming, beep, beep. He's in the fucking golf cart. Oh, wait, that's Roadrunner.
Dude, oh my god. Yeah, that's what... I mean, it wouldn't be that hard to trick OJ, I feel like, if you have the powers of Roadrunner, you know?
I literally just realized the confusing thing, and I was so stupid, because it's Wile E. Coyote that goes after Roadrunner. It was flipped in the question. I was like, oh my god, Jesus Christ.
Wait, what's up?
Yeah, Roadrunner is he tries to be trapped by Wile E. Coyote.
Okay, yeah, no, that's why I wasn't sure if I might have heard you wrong initially. That's why I was trying to clarify, because I was like, hold on. Okay, so we're trying to here's my thing even with OJ, right?
Yes.
So I'm doing the most daring one. We're doing OJ in the Ford Bronco on the highway. I'm doing a classic where Roadrunner doesn't paint shit. Like, that's what okay. I'm doing the classic where I just paint a fake tunnel. And when he's trying to get away from the police. And we know it works, you know?
Just have an off-ramp and be like...
Give him a detour.
Yeah, like...
And then it just goes into a cage.
Go this way. No cop zone. Exit.
It says no cop zone, and it's a fake, tunnel, but it's really a tarp, and he drives through the tarp, and it's federal prison. And it's just like, there you go.
The cops come and just peel him off the wall like wallpaper and roll him up and put him in a squad car.
I understand for any cartoon fans how that could have been very frustrating hearing us try and just fuck up all the Wile E. Coyote Roadrunner stuff. Apologies. Actually, no.
Frick you. Unapologetically
I'm done saying sorry. I'm going to be me.
Just that's me. I do not have to apologize for myself. Sorry, honey. Sorry, sweetie. Bye.
Sorry. Bye. Goodbye. Bye-bye.
Bye. Dude, okay. I cannot... we've talked about this before, but like... I forget it when we're doing our podcast, but when I'm watching other people's podcasts and they're getting something wrong that I know the answer to.
Oh, I know.
It somehow
dude.
Supersedes like, realistically, it's just like, yeah, people have brain farts and forget shit sometimes, but sometimes I completely throw that out the window. I'm listening to a podcast. I'm like, are you stupid? It is this.
Because it feels like you're in on the conversation, but they're not listening to you. You know,
exactly.
It's like your brain is going like, this is the, and I'm sure there's been a couple for our podcast where people are like, fucking hell, dude, that's
guys,
so wrong.
It's Delaware, you idiots. And I'm just like,
oh,
sorry.
God.
I don't know. All right, I got a prank note to hear for you, and it's an important one, and it's a good thing, because either way, we should be bringing people up to speed on this. So it's an important clarification about Don't Pee January. At Cryptic Yeet asks, so for Don't Pee January, do we count crying into that, because it's basically peeing from your eyes? If so, I feel like this year should be an exception, but I'm holding it all in anyways. Guidance would be appreciated.
Crying does not count.
I appreciate you asking.
I appreciate, it's got to be piss from your piss hole. That's essentially the medical term for it. For people who are unaware, again, it's Don't Pee January. If you peed, you already lost. You're going to jail.
Mm-hmm.
You got to hold it in for the rest of the month. But I do want to talk about some specific allegations on this podcast, because I saw on Twitter a few days ago that Gus was blurry photographed like Bigfoot walking out of a bathroom last week.
Okay.
Tony, can you throw up the photo?
Tony, okay. Thank you. Thank you for the opportunity to clarify. Again, I feel as though I did an ample job in the post, but seeing as the photo is still making the rounds, I just saw it in the sun this morning, I appreciate the opportunity. So, I was not peeing in there. I don't know how the paparazzi got in my house. I was not peeing. I was passing stool. I was washing my hands and brushing my teeth in that order, okay? I wasn't peeing. I don't know if you saw in that photo, did you see one drop of pee?
Well, essentially, I mean, you are known to walk out of the bathroom after peeing just soaking wet and dripping with pee, and I did not see that.
Thank you.
But
thank you.
The absence of pee in the photo, it's like, I trust you, Gus, but how can I know for sure?
I mean, I again, if it weren't the pandemic and if we lived together, it would be easier to cross-validate, because we could, as we always did, just go into the hallway and feel each other's ball bumps, you know, to see how much pee has actually been stored up. But I can't prove that to you right now. I'm wearing loose-fitting clothing. A photograph won't do. And you can't get your little feelers on it, so.
Well, what's Sabrina's take on this?
Sabrina's take? Well, first of all, I'm kind of pissed at her because she had to have let the paparazzo in, frankly.
Right.
But second of all, she feels my pee bumps. She's a little skeptical, but you know.
See, that's what bothers you. She's the only witness, and if she's skeptical, then I'm skeptical.
Okay, but she hasn't even. We have two bathrooms. She's not even using my. She wouldn't have even been able to hear the distinct splashing of the stools that would indicate that I'm dropping right. And not slopping, you know?
But if anybody was to make sure that your story was real and true, it would be Sabrina, and you don't even have that.
I will have to get her on the record, perhaps, but she's been subpoenaed in an existing piss-related court case, and I just don't know that she's going to have the subpoena time here for this.
Okay, so. Well, we should really work that out, because I feel like we're going to need to get this story straight. You know, you're going to have to gather some evidence.
Really thought you'd have my back and balls on this one.
Listen, buddy, I want to have your back here. I want to make sure. I would say that other than Thor, we are like we're not the kings, but we're the princes of Don't Pee January. And I just want to make sure, because I want to trust you, but this story, it's the photo looks kind of damning. And we just can't know for sure whether you pissed or not.
I understand. No, I totally understand it. No, that's more than fair. I promise to install some CCTV footage, guys.
Preferably put the camera in the bowl looking up.
Yep, we're gonna have the bowl cam. I'm gonna mount a GoPro right on my little peen, constantly pointing down. I will make sure it's always pointing down. I will not have any erections for the rest of the month, so that the camera will never be off the bowl should I go in the bathroom.
Got it.
And I'll just make sure that there's live coverage 24/7, guys. Link in the description down below. You can watch every corner of my house. So
that's the best we can do for now. But yeah. I would like to maybe next week hear what Sabrina has to say.
Okay.
Because I feel like that's very important to this story, Gus.
Okay.
And again, this isn't me not trusting you, but we don't. And it's like, you know, I don't want to see something like hashtag Gus peed in January. I don't want to see hashtag Gus peed. You know, I don't want to see hashtag Gus Johnson peed himself. I don't want to see these things. And so I want to make sure that the stories are straight before any of those things start to rise, or like, I don't know, the subreddit starts making memes about it or something like that, you know?
Hey, thank you, honestly. I appreciate it. I don't want to see that
I'm
stuff
just looking
either.
Out. I'm just looking out.
Maybe next week we can kick it to a couple minutes of special correspondent Sabrina for some piss-related intel. But for now, I mean, all we can do is hope and pray. So
And that's all we can do. So I guess we just move on to the next pregunta for now.
I completely agree. Thank you, Eddie. Anyway, @Tim Fropp said, I had a realization the other day that bald people can't be ratatouille'd, and it kind of freaked me out, although it did intrigue me. Are there other ratatouille prevention methods? If so, what are they?
bald people can't be ratatouille'd.
Oh my god.
I think they can if you get too many plungers. You know? And they're just moving around like little joysticks.
Wait, you need multiple plungers?
You need at least two. Remy the Rat holds two pieces of hair when he does the, you know.
Oh, yeah, that's true. But he can't operate. Plungers are too big and heavy relative to his body size.
I'm talking about, like, novelty tiny plungers.
Oh, like Larry Boy ear kind of small little things. Like the things they stick on your head for brain scans and shit, huh?
Or sticky hands. You slap two of those on the guy's head.
Oh, dude.
You pull them. You know the little ones you get out from those machines where you put in a quarter?
Yeah, dude, that'd be badass. I just love the idea, the image of Ratatouille with two sticky hands on the top of Linguini's bald head, and he's rearing back, using them as, like, chains for some mighty beast, steering around the kitchen.
Dude, with those sticky hands as a kid, I don't know if I've ever felt more powerful than when you'd throw it at a piece of paper, and it would suck it back towards you.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. It's the most powerful ever. You're like Spider-Man.
The funny thing is, it really does feel like in, like, your tiny second grade brain that you're like, oh my god, this is unlocked opportunity for me. I can reach things over there. Like, you think it's like an advancement in your abilities.
Wow. I can't believe I did this. This is going to be a regular part of my life. And then okay. The sticky hand gets dirty and gross and you're like, oh, this is temporary. My powers are temporary.
You ever try to wash them off?
I don't think I ever tried to wash them off. What happened?
I tried washing them off. It does not work. They just disintegrate even quicker, and they're just shitty, and it's such a fucking bummer, dude. I had one of those. The first one I got one of those, I had a red one. I literally had it for like 2 months because
oh, shit.
I didn't have a lot of like those little kitschy toys and stuff as a kid, and I got that at the Spanish class. I got it. And I was like, I'm going to make this fucker last. And I remember distinctly, I loved pulling it back and slapping it at the wall, even if it didn't stick for the last, like, month or so. But I distinctly remember as a kid pulling it back and the glove hand part was separating from the string. And I was looking at that and I just remember thinking solemnly to myself, ah, probably only a few more pulls left in this old girl. That's so sad.
Oh, fuck. I was trying to think of... I just started a train of thought thing. We're keeping that in. Sometimes you make mistakes, Gus. Sometimes you want to build off something on a podcast, and then your brain farts the bed. That's my new phrase, is farting the bed.
Grody, dude. I hope you never do that ever. anyway, at Gentle Femdom, please, says, disagreement. When at a gas station, my friend thinks it's okay to park at a pump and then go inside to buy stuff. But I think that's a dick move. He said it's just another spot, but it's obviously not. Parking at the pump without using it is uncourteous and rude. Eddie, I have to hear your input on this first.
Huh. I don't know how strong of an opinion I have toward that person's friend. I would never, because the thing is, if you're on a road trip, and you, like, park at the pump, and one person's pumping, and then you go in and get stuff, and then you mm-hmm. wait there as the final guy does it, even though you're not pumping gas. I feel like that's totally fine.
Mm-hmm.
But I just generally, if I'm going into the gas station to first get stuff, I feel like I park, and I don't stop at the pump. But I don't know. What's your opinion on this?
Well, that's the thing is, like, I feel like this has got to be location-specific, because honestly, like, when I go to, like, the gas stations in rural Wisconsin and shit, I'll tell you what, I'm a perpetrator of this shit. Hundreds of times I've parked at the pump and just gone inside. But you do it when there's like eight other free pumps, you know, and the gas station's like right there and you're like, I'm just grabbing some ranch corn nuts in, out, boom, you know?
If it's a popular gas station where there was like one open spot, I think it's a dick move.
Mm-hmm.
But honestly, like, I feel like something in the vein of this would normally piss us off, but I feel like that's okay, man. Because people, I think, you know why it's okay? People used to all the time just pay for gas by doing that.
Mm-hmm.
And so it's like, it's part of the etiquette. Even if you're paying there, if you're buying something inside, if you're getting gas, you can put the car there.
Oh, totally.
I feel like that's fine unless it's not busy.
I think so, too. Man, I miss, really, like, it is so lax sometimes, and especially living out in California now for a few years and seeing how, like, jaded and, like, protected you have to be just because there's people and people want to fuck your shit up, you know? Like, I think about a lot of the stuff, and it's like, I used to, like, never lock my car ever, you know? And I would do shit like, it would be commonplace for me to just go to a gas station and like start the pump and have my car completely unlocked, and then just as it's pumping gas, just go inside and take a piss and like peruse some shit and make a phone call and come out like 8 minutes later and just be like, oh, okay. You know, and not even think of the idea that's like someone could steal gas there, someone could steal my car. Sometimes I'd leave the fucking keys in the car. Jesus Christ.
I think it's part of like age too for it. Like I remember when I was, I think maybe like 11 or 12, thinking that when my dad left while I was home, like when he'd lock the door, I'd be like, he doesn't need to lock the door. I'm home. I was a 12-year-old boy. Yeah. Like, of course he's going to fucking lock the door. Oh, the God. The blind confidence you have when you start being like a conscious, like not adult, but like a kid that starts paying attention, you know, around like 10 or 11,
mm-hmm.
where you're like, oh, I'm like an adult now. Oh my God. I thought that for so long.
It's insane. Like, yeah. I remember getting frustrated in so many little areas like that of like, Mom, what the heck? What are you doing? Like, leave me alone. Let me go do this thing with people. Like, what are you doing? You know, it's like, bro, you're 12.
Yeah, you know, in your head where you're like, you are treating me like a kid and I am 11. It's like, yeah, that's of course, you know, it's just I wonder, have you ever had one of those where something really pissed you off as a kid that your parents did, and then you're like, wait, no, I was a fucking Dumbo kid, and I didn't realize.
Oh, man, well, yeah. Well, yeah, I'd have to tell you this one off podcast. I'm sorry, I hate doing that shit.
No, that's all right.
but other than that, I certainly had stuff that I just thought was dumb and that I even still kind of think was dumb. You know, like my mom would want to take – when I got a cell phone in like eighth grade, you know, my mom would want to say sometimes like, I'm going to take your phone at the end of the night so you're not staying up late and texting people and on it all the time. Because I would do that. You know, I was going to do that anyway. Too. But she'd take it and I would be like, this is so dumb. Like that was one of the first big issues in my mind where I was like, this is fucking stupid. Like this just feels really, really dumb. And of course I was like a, you know, preteen kid who's like, fuck you, I'm gonna take this. But I would just like, my mom had no clue and she still to this day doesn't have anything other than a flip track phone that she doesn't use for months at a time. Mm-hmm. So I would just give her like old shit, like old, like dead, like cell phones and stuff. Or sometimes if she wasn't looking, I'd just go on the other end of the room. And I'd go, Mom. And I'd like wave and hold up an old calculator and just set it on like an obscure dresser. Okay. Have a good night. You know? I almost never fucking did it, but it just was like that kind of shit specifically pissed me off. But I guess I can't think of any stuff that I've come around on. Can you?
I think of certain things like I didn't get coasters for a while when I was a kid. I was like, what? It's water. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like I didn't, and I'm talking about like pretty young, you know, like 8 or 9, where I was like, why? I don't understand what water's gonna do to wood, because I was a kid.
Yeah.
But like I really was like, this is so fucking dumb that I have to use coasters. like, of course. But I that's the blind confidence I'm talking about, is our parents would be fully grown adults being like, hey, this is a thing that was invented for a reason. Please use it. And I'm going like, I think all these people got it wrong. I think these coaster things are fucking bullshit. Like, I don't even know what they're for. Like, imagine the confidence in that tiny body. Like, I think every adult is wrong about this coaster situation.
Guys, you seeing this? What the hell? Dude, honestly, and I still feel like, you know, I'm a ways away from being a parent, hopefully, you know, in terms of being ready and stuff. But especially as I've been
for
moving into this.
For me too. Sorry, I wasn't saying like, you. Sorry to interrupt. Definitely. But I was like, I can't. Okay, go ahead.
Eddie and I will not be having a child for quite some time. But I think especially as I've been doing like a bunch of house stuff here, like I'm proud of the fact that so much of my brain is still rooted in that, like, hey, you are making $400 a month in college, survive mindset, you know? Like, I like that a lot of the, like, just food shit. You know, I obviously get, like, Postmates and stuff a lot, but it's just like, dude, I could eat a can of green beans, like, microwaved on a plate and some fucking a brick of ramen for the rest of my life for dinner. I love that shit. Yeah. But, you know, I like buying cheaper shit, and I almost never buy new stuff, especially like furniture and clothing and stuff. But as we've gotten like this house now, and we've not bought, you know, we're still renting, folks at home, but you know, I'm buying some stuff where it's like, okay, well, it makes sense. Like, I should get a sofa for the first time in my life, you know, a new one that's not our $100 Craigslist one that we got a few years out of. Hell yeah, you know. But I need to get a table. I should get this chair or something. And it just kills me. And I'm like, I know that this is a smart investment and that I'm going to use this for a while. But I'm starting to see now, it's like, oh my God, if I had a kid and he fucking left a cup on this fucking table,
I
would be like, you little bitch. I was the first fucking table. You have any idea how long I fucking worked for that table, you son of a bitch? So now I'm like, oh, I get it, mom and dad, for like freaking out about that kind of shit. Of like, you have no fucking clue. You can just walk around here, piss in the pants drawer, leave shit on the table. Uh-uh.
Dude, I really think, and you can try to understand it even as you get like older as a teen and be more appreciative. But until you like, I think until you hit your kind of mid-20s, you're like, oh, I did not understand how much effort it took to keep me alive, you know?
Oh, my God.
Like, I was just thinking, like, when I was back home sometime talking to my mom, I don't even remember. Might have been pre-pandemic, but where I was like, it just hit me that she made me breakfast every morning. Imagine waking up every morning and making three kids breakfast. How much fucking work is that, dude?
Like, that is insane. Especially, like, my mom will still do that sometimes. She's got, you know, two kids in the house right now, four.
Mm-hmm.
But it's, like, the fact that into high school and shit, like, you'll wake up at, like, 6 a.m. and be like, I made French toast for everybody and there's eggs and shit, and I'm going to send you off with a PB&J on the way to school. And for my mom, I packed four fucking lunches off of homemade bread and, like, reused Tupperware containers and old yogurt shit, like, washed out and stuff. Like, fucking hell, dude. Like, oh, thank you, mom and dad. Like, goddamn.
That's I thanked my mom for it, and she kind of laughed, and she's like, "It's what you do when you have kids." And I was like, "Yeah, but like, that it hurts my brain to think of that,
that
effort right now."
So shitty. I would be like, my kid would probably just die. Like, I couldn't keep. I can't take care of my own self. I would forget such basic shit of like, oh my God, dude, like, you have been locked in the bathroom waiting for me to wipe you for 4 days. I'm sorry. Crust it off, maybe pick it off, turd chips at this
God,
point.
Jesus Christ. No.
Anyway.
Not that.
Thank
Not
you, Mom. Love you.
Dude, yeah, I don't know. A lot of that, were we even on a question? What got us here?
Oh, it's the gas pump stuff. Oh, man.
Oh, yeah. So, you know, I feel like your friend's fine.
Yeah.
I just completely forgot we were on that.
This has been a catch-up episode. It's good to, yeah, we got a lot of shit to talk about and stuff. And
yeah, we're especially, a couple things I wanted to say. Well, one, I think we're going to be getting more guests soon, but I definitely, you know, during this chaos week, we were like, let's not, you know, put that pressure on somebody.
Mm-hmm.
But, I saw people asking about the podcast merch. I finally got word back about it. The podcast merch is shipping out now. I believe the beer koozies are going to be later than the other ones. Really sorry, you know, COVID shipping stuff. We really have, like, no control over that.
Mm-hmm.
So apologies for the time for that. Anyways, guys, I just wanted to update them. What? You going to fucking sue me, dude? You going to fucking sue me, dude?
Subpoena you.
You didn't. You have to go to a judge for that.
Tony, make me serving Eddie a subpoena.
I won't grab it.
Make him grab it.
How did you get that?
Make him grab it.
How did you make him grab it? What's Tony gonna make a fake arm? He can't do that. It's too much effort.
Tony,
I'm not gonna grab it, Gus.
Tony, make an arm of Eddie grabbing and signing the subpoena and make him spell
That's
his name
way
wrong.
Too much work. No, Gus, I'm not going to grab it. I'm not. How did you get a subpoena?
Actually, Tony, I got a subpoena off of
Hey, Tony, can you hit Gus with a train again?
Tony, could you just not even...